Hello friends, welcome to this YouTube video program. Friends, we are discussing about the concept of different units that has been kept in different courses of MA education program of Indira Gandhi National Open University. We have started our discussion from the first course of first year program of MA education, that is the first course is MES 011. This is the course code and course title is Understanding Education. We have already discussed few of the units in our earlier YouTube video programs. We have already discussed unit 1, unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, and also we have discussed the last unit, that is unit 5, in our last YouTube video program, that is socio-philosophical basis. So today we are going to discuss the sixth unit of this course MES 011, Understanding Education. The unit title is Education, Some Significant Historical Developments. So friends, let us try to understand first that this unit basically addresses the concept of the historical development, the concept of, you can say, development of education as a discipline or as a subject. In my earlier program, I have discussed that every discipline is having certain characteristics. Okay, just like you can say a discipline is having certain perspectives and certain context, just like every discipline is having a philosophical perspective, a historical perspective, an intellectual perspective, a social perspective, or you can say a political perspective. So as like education as a discipline, education as a subject, it has also its own perspectives. Just like yesterday we discussed about the sociological perspective, that is socio-philosophical basis of education, how education acts, or the role of education acts as a, you can say, as an instrument or tool for social development, for social change and mobility. Okay, that we have already discussed. Then we have also discussed that for development of culture, for preserving the culture, for transmitting the culture from one generation to another generation, how education plays a very important role. Okay, so accordingly, there are other perspectives of this discipline. Just like today we will discuss about education, some significant historical development. It means this is the historical perspective of the discipline of education. So friends, if we'll go through the discipline of history as a subject, history as a discipline, the discipline of political science as a subject, the discipline of chemistry, physics, botany, zoology, economics, sociology, English literature, you will find that every discipline is having its own history, own chronology and own development. Okay, so here also, education being a discipline, it has its own history, it has its own chronology, it has its own development. Okay, so when we talk about the right to education, that means education as a right for the children of this country, for the children of India, you will find that the right, education as a right, this is not the development of overnight. Means you will find that the work behind education as a right, that has been started even before independence. Okay, so you will find this is also reflected in our constitution. You will find many articles, in many schedules of our constitution. This has been mentioned regarding education, just like in Article 45, you will find that this has been mentioned that the elementary or the primary education should be free and compulsory. Okay, so now in Article 21A, now education has been kept as one of the fundamental right with other rights of the citizen. So now state, this is the responsibility of the state to provide free and compulsory education to the children, that is from age 6 to 14, that is you can say the elementary education. So that's why, you know, education is a right. This is not the development of overnight. Or you can say that at a certain this has been developed. Means the work behind for making education as a right, that has been started, quite before. So when we talk about, the historical development the chronology of the discipline or the subject of education, you will find that there are a huge concept you will get, huge developments you will get, and all such things that are supposed to discuss to understand properly about, the historical development of education, how this subject or how this discipline has been emerged, and further how this has been practiced as an institutional manifestation. Okay, so we are studying education as a subject at the undergraduate level, at the postgraduate level. Okay, so one of the branch of this subject, that is teacher education, that is also being practiced for preparing teacher at the undergraduate level or also at the postgraduate level. So friends, today we'll discuss about the historical perspective or the developmental perspective, the chronology of education, that has been practiced as a subject or as a discipline. You see, this unit, unit 6, this has been, you will find that, the content that has been kept in this unit, it covers a huge period, so far as age is concerned, so far as years is concerned, you will find that the discussion that has been started from the practices from the ancient Indian education system towards the post-independence developments, means towards the modern system of education. So that's why the ancient system of education, then Indian education in medieval and modern time, that is also part of this unit. Then further, the educational process and system that is prevailing at this society, that means at the post-independence period, that is also being discussed in this unit. So that's why, friends, in other courses of MA education program, further we will discuss the detail about the historical development. But here from this unit, you will just get a type of overview. Okay, overview of the ancient system of education, then the medieval system of education, then further the post-independence education at the post-independence period. So that's why very briefly this unit has been developed, and as I have already said that this course is just like a bridge course, because the students, those have not studied education from their graduation level, they will acquaint themselves with the educational discourses, with the basic concept that has been discussed in education. So specially this course has been kept keeping in mind those group of students. So that's why from the very beginning of this program, we have discussed about the historical development. Okay, so further this has been discussed with detailed elaboration in different other courses. So friends, the learning outcomes of this unit, we can say that to understand ancient India, post-Vedic and Brahminic education, then to explain the system of education in Dharma Shastras and the Buddhist and Islamic periods, then further to describe education under the East India Company, the constitutional provisions for education and the national policy of education, and further another learning outcomes will be explain the work of the various commissions, committees and initiative taken by all the 5-year plans and the current affairs in education. So friends, few things that's not mentioned in this unit, just like the recent development, you can say the recent development is we have now the National Education Policy, NEP 2020. Just before a couple of days, that has been approved by the cabinet of Union Government. So now you will find the new policies, the new education system that will be implemented across the country. So that is not a part of this unit. Still then, as an education student, as a master student, you should be acquainted with the present development. So friends, in this program, as you know, this unit is a huge unit. First, we'll discuss about the ancient Indian education. Then further in our second program, we'll discuss it in three different small video programs. First, we'll address the education system or the development of education during the ancient education, Indian education period. Then further, in another video, we'll discuss about Indian education in medieval and modern times. And further, in our third program, we'll discuss the post-independence developments, okay, the educational developments that has been occurred in the post-independence period. So friends, now first concentrate yourself on the ancient Indian education system, how it was prevailing at that time. You see, if our country, you'll find that we have a very huge system of education, or we can say from the very beginning of ancient Vedic system of education, the great institutions of this country, just like the Nalandas, the Takshashilas, once upon a time that was the flourished, educational institutions. Okay, you might have studied from different literature, from different sources, that the students, the intellectuals from across the world, okay, they were coming to study. They are coming to stay in Nalanda and Takshashila, and they were engaging themselves in studying. Okay, so that's why you will find that so far as education system of the country India is concerned, we have a very huge history of education. So that's why when you talk about the ancient system or the ancient Vedic education, you will find that the students or the disciples, they were studying at the Gurukul system. Okay, so what they are doing, they were studying, at the same time they were also engaging themselves in different life activities or different, you can say, life skills. At the present time, what we are discussing in our curriculum, that is all about the life skills related to values, related to different activities that further that helps the individual, helps the person for living one's life. So you see, at the Vedic system of education, at the ancient Vedic education, you will find that in the Gurukul system, whatever the guru was saying, whatever education process was continuing between the guru and between the gurus and the disciples, that is not only based upon the content, rather that was also based upon the behavior, that was also based upon the observation, that was also based upon the experience of the child, experience of the disciples, of the students. Okay, so when we talk about the ancient Vedic system of education, then definitely certain points that we should discuss, that is the knowledge and experience. So the disciples, they were getting knowledge, at the same time they were also acquainting themselves with different types of life activities. They were gathering, they were getting many new experiences, and that experiences further helps the individual for living one's life. Then further, the ancient Vedic system of education, the another feature of Vedic system of education, you can say that is the sublimation of instincts. Okay, so we have, every individual is having having their instincts. Okay, instincts means, this is, you can say, what to do and what not. Let you want to do something, so whatever action you will do, whether that action is socially desirable or socially undesirable. Okay, so that's why many a time it is not necessary that we will exhibit all our instincts. Okay, so instincts regulate the person. So that's why sublimating the instincts, controlling the instincts, is also part of part of education during the ancient Vedic system of education. Okay, so further, you can say spiritual education is also part of ancient Vedic system of education. So you see, one is the you can say the abstract world, and other is the concrete world. we the people are living in a complete world. We observe the things, we are maintaining a worldly life, you can say worldly life means we are engaging ourselves with material satisfaction. Okay, but at the same time, for true education, only material education, or to be a materialistic and only realizing this material world is not enough. At the same time, one should develop one's spirit, one should develop the spiritual, concept of certain things, means how the things are happening. So to concentrate oneself, to introspect oneself, and to develop one's imagination about how the things are happening, and how this world is existing, how you can say the how the season, how the everything is happening in this world in a very systematic way. So the realization of self, realization of worldly happenings, so that is also another part of you can say the ancient Vedic education. Then further, you can also say the another feature of ancient Vedic system of education, that is the growth of character and personality. You see, in the Gurukul system, this is the part of teaching that guru, the disciples and the students, they were developing certain certain moral education, certain value education. Okay, so they were developing those values among themselves, and further they were also practicing those values in their life. So that's why for developing a character, a good character is also part of education at that time. Okay, so we call that, you see, if you lost money, then you have not lost anything, and you have lost health, you can say you have lost something. But if you have lost your character, then we say that you have lost everything. So friends, building character, a good character for the society, to be a very good human being, okay, and will work for the society, for the development of this human being, human civilization. Okay, so that is one of the very important aim of education. So that's why in the ancient Vedic system of education, you will find that the one of the feature of education is development of all round personality, at the same time development of good moral values, good character. Then further, another you can say feature, that is the fulfillment of duty. You see, every individual, every person in this world should be dutiful, should be responsible. So that's why education teaches us to be a dutiful person, a responsible person. Okay, responsible towards the society, responsible towards the civilization, responsible towards this country, towards this nation. So in ancient Vedic system of education, it teaches us, this is one of the features, that one should be deeply inclined towards performing one's responsibility, to discharging one's duty. Then further, protection of culture. You see, our culture, we consider that our culture is a very rich culture. Everyone's culture is a rich culture. And India is a country, you will find that here we are practicing a multiple culture, a diversified culture. Every part of this country, you will find that the languages, the other the cultural practices, the customs, traditions, rituals, that is different. Okay, so that's why we have a huge diversity in sense of culture and our practices, but we consider all these diversities as our strength, but not as our weaknesses. So these diversities help the individual, help this nation to emotionally integrated and to work for the development of this country, work for the development of this nation. So friends, ancient Vedic system of education, it also talks about the protection of the culture, how to protect this culture and how to transact this culture, how to transmit this culture for another generation, for a new generation. So these are the certain, you can say, basic feature of the ancient Vedic system of education. Then when we talk about the post-Vedic education, we can also talk certain aspects of education or features of education, that is realization of true knowledge. What is the true knowledge? So true knowledge, that is, you can say, this is not only abstract thinking, rather that you can justify. That knowledge you can experience, that knowledge you can observe. So that's why realization of ultimate relation of soul with the absolute happenings, then further you can say that the realization of what is happening in this world is also one of the feature of the post-Vedic education. Then further this has also been discussed in the Brahminic education system. Though the Brahminic education system was some extent religious in nature, means it was considered that the education system was mostly religious in nature, but at the same time you will find that many beautiful, many good features that has been addressed the Brahminic system of education, just like the character building, just like your ancient Vedic system of education. This has also discussed here. Then full growth of personality, the all-round development of human personality, okay, self-reliance, self-regard, one should get self-regard, means there should be certain regard towards work, regard towards individual is having having their existence, having their realization, having their you can say a thinking process, okay, having their ideas. So that should be regarded. That is one part of, you can say, personality as per the Brahminic system of education. Then further you can say that self-control. So every individual can practice certain self-control. Okay, just like you can say the sublimation of instinct. We all have our instinct. How to control the instinct and accordingly how to act as per the need and interest of the society is also one of the features of the Brahminic system of education. Then beginning of education at an appropriate age, at what time proper education should be given to the human child, that is also one part of education. Then further, under the all-round development of education, the physical, mental, social, spiritual development of education, that was given importance. Then you can say the social ideals, well-regulated life, how to make one's life disciplined, okay, how one can work for the society, that was also the feature of this Brahminic system of education. Then the relationship between teacher and students, the relationship between teacher and taught. Okay, so just like the Gurukul system of education, you will find both the teachers and students were living together, staying together, and teaching learning process was not just like today's schooling system, that 6-7 hours the students will come and they will study and in a school and teacher will teach. But at that time you will find that the relationship between teacher and student was a 24/7 matter, means the students will live with the gurus, live with the teacher in a Gurukul ashram, and they will continue throughout their studentship life with their gurus, with their teachers. So that's why this is one of the beautiful concept, means for proper development of personality, for proper development of you can say the intellectual, social, physical and other aspect of human development, that was being practiced in the Gurukul system of education. Then further we can also discuss about education system in the Buddhist period. At that time, just like your Brahminic system of education, friends, in our next program we'll discuss about this Buddhist system of education. The concept is very vast, so that's why it's not possible to complete in one video. So we have already discussed about the ancient Vedic system of education, and the other aspect of education we'll discuss in our next video. Thank you.